Hello and welcome back to our RedRun challenge in Monster Hunter 4 Ultimate, where we have got a high-rank Shigaru Magala to kill. But first, I'm gonna actually head back to Valhabar and do a little bit of preparation for this, because I want to actually get to HR7, and this thing can hit hard. So I think what I'm gonna do is I'll go ahead and probably make these Brachy Braces, considering I can still get that auto tracker just by swapping the gem over. And that way I'll have a pretty decent amount more defense. So, equipping those. And I'm really considering making this, even though I would actually lose auto tracker if I did. What am I looking for? That's right. This is what I'm looking for. Yeah, I would lose auto tracker for this, but it would also provide more defense. I'll see what I can get for upgrading the Brachy arms. Let's see how that goes. Definitely able to upgrade a few times here. And are we on the same page with everything? No, we can still upgrade these Regio Greaves. Wow, I didn't even use my advanced armor spheres here. No wonder the defense was so low. Well, that's at least better than what we had. And I'll go ahead and toss some heavy armor spheres into this helm, because it's got a lot of slots and is thus very flexible. So, I think that's about as good as we can hope to get right now. Yeah. Alright, well, that should still be a pretty decent upgrade. Yeah, we're at 402 defense now. That's good. Generally, if you've got like 300 or more, you can do just fine against Dalamadur. And having more makes it just easier. So yeah, having more still is not bad. And every slot is taken up, but I actually technically have two spaces, because I can get rid of those health gems in the helm. Or, what the hell gems are those in the helm? Oh right, they're countering some negative points in health, but yeah. I won't get to minus 10, so I could probably maybe squeeze in constitution or bleeding. But neither of those is really going to help too terribly much against a Shagmag. So now I'm going to check and see whether or not I can send my cats anywhere interesting. I can send them after Acer Regios with a star, no less. So let's go ahead and find our melee onslaughts. They'll be handy. And then we'll want the best ranged cat we can find. And then may as well send in a bomb onslaught to deal with that Renoplos. It's a little overkill, but it works. And Fair Lady for the treasure hunting. Alright, so that ought to be just fine. So now let's get back to the Gathering Hall. Yep, he has indeed informed me. I will now. Yep. Sure. Alright, let's stop this wheel. But first, a meal. short on mega potions again. So let's grab that and these. And let's grab some dung because he does have a grab. Not that I expect to be hit by it. We'll bring honey as well as a couple combo books to make sure that our mega potions succeed. Getting rid of our various temperature drinks, our paintballs, our antidotes. And we don't need bug nets or pickaxes. Let's see, what else can I use? Not gonna use the bombs, because he's not gonna go to sleep. Mossland jerky, however, and those null berries that I said I would remember to bring. Beyond there, I think we're pretty good. Maybe the steam bombs would actually be useful here. Yeah, because he won't leave the area. Yeah, I think we're good with what we've got. So, let's get to it. Stuff just because it's here. Yeah, I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to turn these into first aid med pluses. Because that way I can at least keep my potions. That only costs me honey, and I can actually get quite a bit of honey. So yeah. Hey, big fella. Oh, yeah, you are a big one. And you are already being ridden. And down he goes. Base is right there, and I won't really want to be in front of it at any other point in time, so I'm gonna break those horns first. Or I'll just miss with almost everything. That was close. Alright, buddy. Gonna grab this real quick. Hope you don't mind. He mines! But that's okay. He was too late. That jerk. It's amazing that I can call things jerks for moving out of the way of my attacks, when really that's the perfectly reasonable thing to do. I didn't even really dodge there, because I guess I got, like, poked by something. But still got the sharpen, and I ran straight in the path of that. I just get a null berry at the ready here. In fact, I'll go ahead and eat it. I don't like being infected, especially not against this guy. He hits a bit too hard for that to be pleasant. And I dodged there out of an abundance of caution. No. You are not super pounding me. I've already had my fill of being super pounded by shag mags. At least I think I recall being super pounded. Maybe I was just exploded. Or both. Really, it's hard to keep track. It was a while ago. And now you're mad. Oh, thanks for giving me your tail. I will not complain about getting an extra charge off on it. That was your foot, though. Ouch. Once again, an abundance of caution. Because we've come this far, I don't want to lose this before I get to fighting something really dangerous, like Teostra. I'm very concerned about fighting. Glass Blight is quite possibly the most dangerous status ailment on this run. And he's got it in spades. Oh boy. Thanks, Cat. Good job missing there with everything. I can't rely too much on this rock because it will break if I use it too often as a shield. And I want it to stay around for the duration of the fight, so if I don't need it, I won't use it. Because I want it to always be there when I need it. I want that rock to be my rock. Haven't been getting very many hits in. And that's not good if you want to actually finish a quest on time. But it is, it's okay if you use that to, you know, survive. Aha, I hit you, but you did not hit me. Yeah, survival is always the most important part of this, but failing a quest because of timeout is equally run-ending. Plus, it's not so exciting for you guys watching at home, I would imagine, because it means that I'd be doing just a whole lot of running away. Alright. Yep, go ahead, spit that out over the abyss. That's fine. Oh, hi. If I brought a Farcaster, I could get the subquest supplies. But I didn't, so I can't. Plus, I have to finish the subquest first. It's just the thing I thought about. Yeah, my only way to get back there is to die, and doing that means the run is over. Got a tail flinch, that's good. Yeah, you go ahead and do that. I'm gonna focus on getting smaller hits where I can. That's probably gonna be better for me than trying to charge up with everything. Because I won't always have the opportunity to charge. At least our Seregios sword has been doing a very good job of keeping itself sharp this quest. Okay, here we can actually get a decent charge in. I've actually got a level 140 Shigaru Magala guild quest on my main file. That one's exciting. I've kind of got most of Shagmag's patterns down as a result. So I'm not really that terribly concerned about dying in this quest unless I get some really unlucky little ground explosions. There's the tail. But it's always a risk. And minimizing risk is generally the thing that I want to do. Oh. Oh! I was expecting to be hit like 5 times there. It'd be nice if both my cats showed up at the same time and actually played a Percherosa. I can use the plus 10 health. Also nice would be if I could find a time to mount this thing again. Yeah, I deserved that. That's what I got for noob carving. Oh, thank you. I do not want to eat your very, very explosive breath. That would be bad. And I don't think my health insurance would cover it. There we go. So we can get some more hits in on the face after this. And this time I'll go to the other side of the face and hopefully be able to actually continue hitting it with the supercharge and the round slash after that. So I'll hit on over to this side of the face. There goes one horn. And there was the supercharge, at least. Ground slash didn't do it. Okay, now I need to find a good time to grab that sparkly. And also to quaff a mega, or a first aid med plus, rather. A mega med. There's a good time for that. Oh, right when they started Percherosa. Dang. That's some wasted healing on my part, but at least I'll still get the maximum HP increase. Oh, he's grabbed a cat. Or at least he tried, but he waited too long. This is gonna suck. Thanks, Defender. That actually did not hurt bad at all. But then again, Defender proc'd, and the thing isn't enraged right now, so I can't exactly take that as a representative sample of all the super pounds this thing can do. Speaking of enraging, dang. Well, at least I got that. So, only breaks we have left are horn number 2 and the wings. The wings we might get if we mount him one more time, which I would certainly like to do because that'll make getting the horn easier, along with also making it so that we get the last sparkly he can give us. Okay, yeah, that super pound did a bit more. Still not too terribly much, and that's good. I like not dying. Oh. You're doing this again, despite already being angry. Silly Shagmag. Another mount hit or two should get me on his back again. That's not going to help, though. Alright. Yeah, you go ahead and do that. You going to do a second one? You are. That means I have time to heal. Will 2 be the number? It will not. Uh-oh. Oh, wow, I can block that. Good to know. Like, super good to know. Like, that's a game changer right there. And not the kind that brings a Devil Joe on my head. That kind of game changer is not what we want here. It's kind of weird that we can't climb onto this rock. Like, there's a lot of surfaces where it'd be pretty easy to actually clamber on up. But there are just some rocks you're not allowed to climb. There's our mount. I was off by one with my estimate. So let's see if this does indeed break those wings. It did! So now we've just got this horn left. and I didn't get to the proper side. And everything is broken. Oh, sure, just dodge out of the way, you jerk. Yeah, I really need to remember to get to the proper side if I'm going to mount him. Of course, I don't think I'll really bother with mounting for the rest of this quest. Three times is pretty much the limit where it stops really being worth it. Especially because after three, you don't get the sparkly, which I'm going to grab right now, even though it's probably a very bad idea. And it was actually a just fine idea. No complaint. Though getting a jump attack where you can is still decent. Of course, I missed with it, so... Oh boy. I sure do love missing with everything and then taking a breath for it. Alright, now we get to dip into our own supplies. Nope. Here, have this. Yeah, if memory serves, a jump attack is equivalent to a level 2 charge, so getting a chance to hit with one of those is always good. I hope that hit a leg and not the body. Mainly because the body takes way less damage than anything else. Oh boy. Well, at least we didn't get exploded. That's always a plus when you go through a day without being exploded. Quit hopping around. Let me get a charge in on you. Please? Okay, it wasn't in a good spot, but you did do what I asked. Ooh, multiple times even. Missed with the round slash, though. Excuse me, don't want you just barging on through me. Whoops. Got a bit too close to that. Ah, ow. Thank you for going for the cats there. That could have screwed me, like, royally. Eh. You'll be missed, Rock. Don't want to use my energy drinks. I've still got rations. Alright. We're in a pretty good place right now. Got plenty of healing items left. Got everything broken on him. We should be able to last the rest of this quest easy. Of course, if we take stupid hits like that, I mean, it's not going to help, but... shouldn't end up dooming us. Good job on that flinch, cats. Nice assist. This is gonna hurt. I was kinda hoping you wouldn't hit me till the last one so I could at least let the attack go. Let's just get on over here and heal. Alright, buddy. Do your worst. That wasn't very bad. If that's your worst, I'm totally okay with it. Not everyone's worst is bad, and it's okay for your worst to not be as bad as others' worst. I'm not gonna judge. Alright. Nope. Still nope. Bop. thank you. I want to get rid of this frenzy virus, but I'll settle for an ulberry for now. Yeah, no. Yeah, you go back that way. You're not needed over here. I know, that was mean of me to say. Everyone's needed somewhere. Fine, just avoid me. I see how it is. Overcharged that last slash, but ended up getting a hit for it, where otherwise I would have gotten a miss. So it's all good. If you can turn a hit into a miss, it doesn't matter if you overcharge a little bit. Except the other way around, if you can turn a miss into a hit. If you can turn a hit into a miss, it very much matters that you overcharged. That would be stupid. Thank goodness for being able to block. Unfortunately, I couldn't turn around and block fast enough. Yeah, you go ahead and do that. I'll just be over here. I don't want to find time to sharpen. And thankfully, he's giving it to me. Or at least time to use an ulberry so that I'll have time to sharpen. Okay. Go to the cats. Or rather, cat. Okay, you know what? I can use this. Yep. Just fine. I missed that rock. Hey, I'll take this. Hard to miss when the monster falls over directly in front of you. Okay. This is gonna suck. Or apparently not. This will if I don't dodge, though. Alright. Very nice. This is not so nice. Thanks for putting things where I could hit them with that supercharge at the very least. Yeah, if you can block that roar when he's in the air, he's always going to land in the same spot, so it's actually pretty easy to get a supercharge all charged up right where he's going to be. I'll take this. That could have gone poorly, but it didn't. And I got to give him a bop on the face. Usually I just bop things on the nose, but no, for Shagmag, I bop his whole face. Okay, that was just a miss, and that was not. Ouch. Okay. Oh no! That was close. I'll actually eat this moss munger. That's a pretty good amount of red that I recovered. About a potion's worth. If moss wine jerky can be worth a potion or more, it's always a good idea. Why did I use an energy drink? I still have a million rations. Oh, come back. That is not coming back. That is the wrong thing. You've done the wrong thing, Shagmag. Why have you done the wrong thing? Quit turning about. Just give me a nice opening. That's a good one. Oh, there. I'm doing a pretty good job of not getting exploded. It's always pleasing to do a good job of not getting exploded. Less pleasing when you make a jump attack towards the head and just whiff it. Not gonna hit a good hit zone with this, but at least I'll get a hit. And I hit with the round slash too, that's always nice. Did not manage to block in time. And I rolled into an explosion. That's like the one place you don't want to roll. You're supposed to roll away from explosions. I don't know whether I hit or not. My camera was kind of all up in him. That was spooky. Yeah, you go ahead and do that again. Nice try. Nope. If things could stop exploding for just a moment, that would be great. Okay, at least I hit him. So about the things and the not exploding thereof, please. Yeah, I've been really lucky to not have any of those exploders form underneath me while I was drinking a potion or anything. That's actually a very real danger, and it would be hilarious, but also very terrible if I was, like, super low on health and drinking a potion and had one form under me and kill me. That would be a pretty terrible end to the run, but we could all have a very hearty laugh about it. A hearty, sobbing laugh. Ouch. Yeah, you go ahead and run over my limp form. Now, if you'll excuse me, I've got some not dead to be. Alright, you stopping? Good. That was a miss. Though it looked like my swing dispersed the cloud of virus. That's always interesting visually. Oh, well then, I'll take that. And now we're going to be HR7, so huzzah. I just can't wait until we fight the stuff that we're going to find in HR7. Seriously, Teostra is probably the thing that scares me the most for this run. He's hyper-aggressive, he's got blast for days. And he's got some moves that come out of the gate pretty quick. Like, he can charge instantly, and that's never good for me. So I think we'll probably get him out of the way first among our HR7 key quests, simply because of the danger he represents to us and the run. But hey, we got a dead Shagmag here, which means we get to fight Teo. Gotta count our blessings, you know? Didn't I, like, on top of his tail? I know I already carved it, but... Ooh, we got a plate. We got two plates. I don't know what Shagmag has to do with that, but okay. Alright. So, with the duration of that quest and us having done a pretty decent amount of preparation and looking at stuff beforehand, I think we will just go ahead and not do any more quests this time. Ooh, and we've got a Gormagala in our Everwood. Which means we might do that next time if it's still there, because I can't afford the time to record another session right this moment, or another episode right this moment, rather. But I can certainly at least try to look at that next time. If it's still there, we'll do it. If not, then I guess we won't. Yeah, low-rank Gormagala could probably help us with something or other. I've already lost my train of thought. It's gone. I wonder if we can make any Shagmag stuff that would be useful. I'll take a look at the waste. Nope, didn't want to talk to you. Nope. Still need 500 million carapaces, and wow, we would be just delightful in that. And we would lose auto tracker, of course. But we could actually get it right back with more psychic jewels put in place of the health jewels in our helmet. But that's for another time. So, that's it for this episode. Join us next time when we maybe fight a Gormagala and definitely fight a Teostra. See you then, friends.